In 2009, I proposed in my master's thesis that multimedia technology be used in visual arts. How was the question? In the already existing digital arts class, we were using both technical and artistic elements with Photoshop, making Andy Warhol type photos, taking a photo and replacing part of it with another photo, watercolor brushes to make a photo look like a watercolor and then printing it out on watercolor paper. And the multiple exposure project allowed students to be very creative with multiple pictures to create an unusual multiple exposure. And one of my creative students learned how to use Illustrator techniques. So I introduced filmmaking and web-based programs like Extra Normal to tell stories in this class. Stop-motion animation became a project in art classes. Hand-drawn stop motion, and clay animation.
My Heidi Ho.
This project was a project where students had to illustrate a poem, and Hippo's Hope won an honors award at the Michigan Student Film and Video Festival.
Snow Heidi, slow Heidi, oh Heidi who? With the clouds high above and the sea down below. Where Heidi, there Heidi, scare Heidi who? He looked up at the sky and looked down at the sea. See Heidi, free Heidi, we Heidi way. And he turned and he went home and had cookies and tea. That's Heidi, all Heidi.
Students were as creative as they could be with the filmmaking projects, but we were hindered with incompatible technology.
Why is she so mad? What do we do?
I think something's stuck in her foot.
Oh, I think you're right. Let's get it out. It looks like a tree. Okay.
Then, when the community passed the bond, a door opened and I seized the opportunity to present a new class to our school board. Armed with a degree in graphic design, some marketing classes, and wicked Photoshop skills, I needed to focus on what career-related skills I wanted to teach my students. First, a workshop at the Graham gave me the opportunity to explore industry-standard design thinking models, and then I came up with my own model to teach my students. D is discovery questions to further understand the assignment. I is to ideate a list of ideas or create sketches for a project. C is to create the actual assignment. And E is to reflect on the strengths and weaknesses of the project. We began with simple assignments to get used to the technology. Logos that would later be used in green screen newscasts.
Welcome to Panther Nation News. I'm Michaela.
And I'm Jordan.
The past week, Western High School had a spirit week leading up to the homecoming football game. Each grade showed their spirit by dressing up as the scheduled days of the week.
One of the themes of the week was everyday superheroes. This group of seniors dressed up as doctors, policemen, and a service dog.
Online tutorials to get students better acquainted with the Mac Airs, the new Nikon cameras, Photoshop, and Illustrator. Students used their iPads as tools, reading tutorials while working on the Airs, and then a simple animation assignment was given using any animation app that would allow them to export it to me. I iBooks Author allows students to communicate about themselves using technology. Students had assignments analyzing logos and slogans. Next assignments were built around a food product. Students created a company name and a slogan. They had to do a marketing SWOT analysis. They created magazine advertisements and social media ads. This student went so far as to create a LinkedIn page for her company. And finally, students had to create a commercial, and this group really likes stop motion animation. Now in digital arts, the students are using new Nikon cameras and the Mac Airs to create their assignments and do filmmaking.
One day,
they also are using online technology with their iPads to do animations to tell stories about themselves.
Are you excited?
Yes, I'm nervous about the size of the hill.
Don't worry, we'll start out on a small run.
We got to the resort and I looked up at the giant hill. It was a lot bigger than I imagined and I started to change my mind about snowboarding down it.
Are you sure this is the smallest run?
Yes. You are just going to have to go for it.
I tried to-
Do you want to go to the diner sometime? I'm kind of busy with the new website.
In this Extend the Scene project, students are spoofing Star Wars and using green screen technology, very creative, to do the whole Anakin loses his legs.
Actually, I think you're a little big for one child.
Oh, you're next, Kenobi. Don't even get me started with you.
This is why I tried to kill you. Next.
What do you do?
1 minute you're sympathetic and fat, and then next, always point out our flaws, and then you always say what we're doing wrong.
You destroyed the Republic. You tell so many lies.
I can really use that bear right now.
My basic art classes and 2D design still have to use drawing skills to make their animations. Now we're starting to use green screen technology in the classroom, and we've learned a lot about that. I'm using my iPad to take pictures of every single art project. This allows me to take them home on the iPad instead of carrying hundreds of pieces of artwork home. And then I put them on Twitter so that anybody following me can see what we're doing. I'm also using an online program called Animoto to make little videos of all the students' work. Since I take the pictures of them, I also save them, and then the parents and the students can have a little animated video of their work. I also turn those videos into QR codes so that I can post them on the bulletin board, because we are limited in some of the sizes and spaces of some of the projects we use. Senior Veronica Fritz said, "Art doesn't have to be just drawn, colored, or painted. You can express yourself through technology as well. Multimedia communications has taught me I can express myself by design and creativity through a computer screen. It's a new and extraordinary way to look at art."